Hi, everyone. In this lecture, we'll learn how to design the camera tab. This is our design. The authentication part is in a pretty good shape now. Recall that our tab bar has five tabs: Home, Discover, Camera, Activity, and Profile. In our app, the Home view will show up first after the user was authenticated. Okay, now in this lecture, we'll design the look for the camera view. Let's go back to the project to start working on this. All right. We'll use storyboards. Recall that we factored the storyboard into different small ones and linked them using storyboard references. Our camera UI view controller is in this camera storyboard. The design is pretty simple. We'll first use something to display the posted photo and caption. To do that, search for a UI view in the object library, then drag it to the UI view controller. Let's make it fit the screen width. We'll use it to contain the photo and caption. Also, to enhance user experience, we can darken the background color of the super view. This is a simple way of using color to contrast a view with the super view. You can also add a bottom border to this UI view by faking it using an extremely thin rectangle, as we did in the sign-in view. Anyway, in the object library, let's search for a UI image view for the posted photo. Then, place it on top of the UI view we've just created. You can resize it a bit to make things look balanced. Next, search for a UI text view in the object library. We use this text view to display the caption of the photo. Place it next to the UI image view and resize it so that it has the same height of that of the image view. Actually, let's make both a bit smaller. Now we add auto layout to the UI view. As usual, we need four pieces of information. We want it to touch the top tab bar and the side margin of the scene, then set its height. That's enough information for the system to locate it. Next, we lay out the UI image view with respect to the UI view and the text view. Let's say it's 10 points from the top and bottom, and 8 points away from the left edge of the UI view. As the UI view's height is 100 points, this height can be set to 80 points. Finally, let's set its width so that the image view is a square. We can also update the frames on the storyboard for this image view with the new constraints. For the text view, we're going to let it be 10 points from the top and bottom, and 8 points from left and right. Alright. Then update the frames on the storyboard and add the constraints. Alright, great. This looks good. We now need to drag a placeholder, photo, to the assets folder for the UI image view to signal users that this is for choosing photos. As usual, we can show this placeholder photo by in the attribute inspector of the UI image. Link to this new file. You can use your own placeholder photo. Alright, next. We're going to need a share or post button to the bottom of the view. Simply search for a UI button in the object library and drag it to the scene. For auto layout, we let it be 8 points away from the two margins for consistency with the other views above. For the height, let's say choose something larger than the default height to make our wide button look more balanced. All right, pretty good, right? And don't forget to change the dot title to something like share or post. All right, great. The final piece is color. We can set this title to a black color. And then set the background color of the button to something light. Actually, as the super view has a light color, we should set the button title to a bright color, and then set the button background color to a dark color. Alright, great. Let's run the app and see. We actually use a black color for the button background for consistency. By the way, in the next lecture, we'll make this camera feature functioning. We'll learn to upload posted photos to the database. Okay, let's log in the app using a valid user account. Okay. Fantastic. All right. See you next time.